last Thursday.
The week is winding down. We can almost see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'm ready for it. How about you? Got big plans for the weekend? I'm already planning ahead. Morning, Rebecca. All right, let's go. Good morning, everybody. Today is Thursday, June 29th. We're live here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. My name is Nathan Gray, and you're watching 3 Points. First off, earlier today in Mosul, Iraq, Iraqi government troops have recaptured the mosque in Mosul where ISIS proclaimed itself califate 3 years ago. Califate is any territory under the leadership of an Islamic steward known as a khalifa. While some ISIS fighters remain west and south of Mosul, the loss of Mosul marks a huge victory against ISIS, marking the end of the Iraqi half of the conflict. The cost of the battle for Mosul has been huge, with an estimated thousands of civilian casualties and approximately 900,000, nearly half of the pre-war population, fleeing from the city. Moving right along, earlier today in Sydney, Australia, Australian police charged Catholic Cardinal George Pell, a top advisor to Pope Francis, with multiple sex crimes. Pell is the Vatican's economy minister and the highest-ranking Catholic Church official to ever face such charges. According to police in Victoria, Australia, where Pell was a country priest through the 1970s, he faces, quote, multiple charges in historic sexual offenses, end quote. While no details on the charges or the victims have yet been released, Pell is expected to appear before the Melbourne Magistrates Court on July 18th. And lastly, yesterday in Little Rock, Arkansas, Michael Reed Tate was arrested and charged with first-degree criminal mischief, defacing an object of public interest, and criminal trespassing after he drove his car into the 6-foot granite monument of the Ten Commandments less than 24 hours after it was unveiled on the Arkansas State Capitol grounds. Reed destroyed a similar Ten Commandments monument at the Oklahoma Capitol ground 3 years ago, but this time he streamed it all live right here on Facebook. According to local media, the monument was financed from over $26,000 in private donations. That about finishes off the gourd for today. Until next time, you've been watching 3 Points.